I've always wanted to shoot a short film using the martial arts of Avatar: The Last Airbender.
So I have four masters here that are going to teach us four different styles.
This is your first punch-for-punch short that you're directing.
I'm honestly nervous.
I'm going to be there with you. We're going to make a sick short.
Yo, I'm about to show you one of my favorite animes was just turned into a live action, Avatar: The Last Airbender series. It takes elements of earth, wind, water, and fire and combines it with martial arts, which you know I'm a big nerd about. And Netflix does not hold any punches on it, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So I want you to just experience it, and then I want you to tell me what you think.
Okay, sweet.
Cool.
Let's do it.
Brothers and sisters, we're under attack!
Ooh, sick. Air slide. That's cool.
That's cool. Using his air powers to fly around. Nice wire work.
That had to hurt. Like, you saw that?
Yeah.
Guys were tacoing on those steps. I like the fact that they're not only just bending, they're actually using the martial arts in close combat.
Yeah, you can take them out of their costumes and I'd be able to tell who's who still. So I just saw some air. I saw some fire.
Right.
It's two more, right?
Right. You have earth and water. You're gonna see fire fighting a lot of these people, okay? Fire wants all the smoke.
Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah.
So this fight right here is gonna depict what earthbending looks like.
Oh no, toasted, roasted. So I'm noticing with the earth style is that you do not have to be flexible to do the earth style. It's all about strong forms, two fists, pulling things together. It's like you're actually lifting rocks.
Yeah.
Here we go, here's some water bending.
Oh, sick.
Like water bending is like way more tentative. It's got a little bit of that flow that fire bending has.
But see how it's also circular, kind of like air?
Yeah. So I'm really noticing there's like a distinct physical movement style behind each magic set. It doesn't feel made up.
No, they're actually connected to real martial arts. They each have a characteristic that blends perfectly with these four elements. And I love it so much. I've actually always wanted to shoot a short film using the martial arts of Avatar: The Last Airbender. I think with your help and your eye, I can probably knock this out of the park.
Yeah, I don't actually know anything about these styles. I don't know anything about Avatar.
Well, the great thing is that I have a friend. He was a supervising stunt coordinator of Avatar: The Last Airbender, and he said he'll give us a call to give us some pointers of what we can use in order to make our short come to life.
I'm gonna be there with you, I'm gonna learn, we're gonna make the sick short.
Hell yeah, yeah. Zoom in on this.
Hey Jeff, thanks for joining us.
Absolutely, my pleasure. Big fan of your work, guys. I love what you guys do.
Oh, thank you. We really appreciate that. Gui and I just got done watching the new Avatar: The Last Airbender series. It's bonkers.
It was a huge show, large collaboration.
You're technically like the stunt avatar of Team Avatar. You have to be able to speak everybody's language and understand all the languages that are being spoken, as well as being able to teach it.
It was really my job to stay ahead of things, make sure things were planned and we understood the direction of where we were going.
That's awesome.
And get the story told. It is an absolutely amazing story.
Yeah.
We can't help but notice how distinct the movement is. Were you inspired by a martial arts discipline for each different element?
Absolutely. We wanted to honor the mythology. So those martial arts, like Baji Quan and Chan Chuan, they reflected fire because it was fast and snappy and hard. Air was Bagua Zhang, which was to the original, and Chan Chuan. Tai Chi was water, which gave us our softness and flow. And then earth. Earth was Southern Fist martial arts. So Bugar, Hungar, like those hard martial arts with the solid stances. We hope that each of those elements come out distinctly.
You guys completely nailed it.
Yeah.
Gui wanted to try directing a short film.
Yes.
So we're gonna teach him. It's going to be four different masters having a very brief showdown. Do you have any other suggestions for the other styles that we should really focus on?
My suggestion is to start with breath. the characters just evolve from there. So for example, waters, Tai Chi is the martial art, and when you use the breathing, it's a push-pull. So everything starts with your diaphragm, you breathe in, exhale all of that air out so you can feel the push, and then naturally you would help that pull. Earth is kind of the exact opposite in terms of its hardness. You would breathe in, fill your belly, and then it would be a hard, almost ki movement. And then that really gave us that
big sign. Yeah. I really appreciate the love that you have for not only this IP, but also for Hong Kong cinema. So I hope to do it justice because you guys did an amazing job.
Well, thank you so much. I'm really excited to see you guys.
Cool. Thanks, Jeff.
Thank you so much, Jeff.
Let's do this.
We got work to do.
Yeah. Let's go.
Good morning, Niko.
Morning.
Thank you so much for coming out because I really do need your help.
Okay.
I have four masters here that are going to teach us four different styles. Now, my brain can't take all this information in one day, so I'm really going to need your help on this one.
All right.
All right? So I got us Brendan Huer and Terrell Coda. They'll represent earth and air. Those are your guys.
Sweet.
Okay. I got Brian Cartago and Jerry Quill who do water and fire. Our goal at the end of the day is to gather moves from each specific style that we can put together to create an amazing short film with the help of Livenberg.
Can't wait for that part.
I'm so down.
Yeah.
I'm excited.
All right, well, let's get learning so we can actually make this cool fight scene.
Let's go.
Fire.
All right, so Brian, we're gonna start with fire.
Yep, the style I'm representing today is a very old style. Not a lot of people know it, but they know its most famous practitioner, Jet Li. It's called Fanzi Quan, and it is a very aggressive chain punching style. And I'm also representing long fist. Like it is exemplifies the fire style because of the finality of the movements in fire accentuate the last explosive force of energy that they have to emanate fire from their fists or their feet or whatever limb they're striking with. And its primary distinctive strike is called a rolling punch.
Oh, sweet.
Right, so we're gonna learn that today.
Okay.
It is both used defensively and offensively. It essentially looks like two punches and then you roll and use a rotational force with your hand here that goes through that way. Mm. And as you come down, you're evading. Throw it straight again, but also use it as a grab. Okay. You could also use it as, depending on the stylistic expression that you want.
You really just gave me a defensive and offensive move in one technique. And the aggressive nature of it is so similar to what we see in Avatar The Last Airbender, with the firebenders being deemed the villains of the story. And that's amazing, so thank you.
You're welcome.
Earth.
Brendan, what are we going to be learning about today?
So today, the style we're gonna use to embody the earth style is called Baji Quan. So much of what we do in Baji Quan is about grounding yourself into the earth. So from here, before every movement, you'll sort of drop and move in, drop and move in. All the force moves into our opponent instead.
Awesome. So we need to learn an attack move, a defensive move that encapsulates the spirit of this style.
The very first move we're gonna start with is what's called a Hung Quan. So from here, our right arm is cocking back for this Hung Quan, and we're turning our waist into the Hung Quan. It's all about using my hips to drive that in. From here, instead of striking with a fist, I can move in, strike with my whole arm, and make it a takedown.
You're punching with your whole body with that elbow move, and your whole body is just one unit moving in the whole time.
Exactly.
So you're like a giant rock.
Like a giant boulder.
Okay, how about a defensive move?
So the first one is gonna be called Fu Bao To, which just means the tiger cradles its head, or tiger holds its head.
Okay.
Tiger holds its head, and cat watches its face. Not only am I using this arm to block, but as he throws this punch, I'm stepping off the line and I'm moving into Terrell. Boom, this way, right? And from here, I'm just dropping and flaring this elbow out. Bam, to hit. And under Terrell. Bam. Or I can just drop him back this way. I have a lot of options, right? It's all the same technique. Thank you for being such a good sport.
Destroyed.
Water.
All right, so my hands are still a little swelled up from doing fire style. So I think I need to cool it down perfectly with some water, and we have Jerry. So thank you so much, Jerry.
All the martial arts we'll be using to represent water will be soft-based. Primarily, it's Tai Chi Chuan-based, or just Tai Chi in Western terminology. It's very soft, but has a lot of explosive power at the end.
Kind of has that Bruce Lee idea of it flowing and then crashing.
Water can flow or it can crash.
Yeah. I need an attack.
Okay.
And I need a defensive move.
If Gui gives me the jab cross, I'm gonna use circles to parry. Boom, so Tai Chi is very circular. With other styles, it'd be very straight, straight, circle, circle. I'm gonna do my single whip. I'm gonna hook into his arm. This would be palm strike. This can be neck chop or a nice little clench here. From here, this hook hand is already set up right underneath the chin. We're gonna raise it, rise. From there, we're going to absorb the force back into ourselves and use our Gui from Tai Chi to get our explosion.
So circular movements to absorb the strikes coming at you.
That's right.
You're taking their energy, stepping in and giving them a palm strike, right? I try to flow as much as possible in life, but sometimes you gotta crash. So thank you so much, Jerry.
Thank you.
Appreciate you.
Air.
The style for air is called Bagua Zhang. So it's another internal Chinese martial arts. For air, it's very flowy, light on the feet, and evasive. So we're gonna start with the first, he's gonna go for a left jab. First one, we're gonna parry, and we're gonna redirect with the left, get into the behind of our opponent, because we never wanna stay direct line.
When Brendan was showing me Baji Xuan, he was all about driving in, and you're not doing that at all.
No, we wanna go around circular motion.
Interesting, very wind-like.
Yeah.
Would you consider this to be a defensive move?
Defensive move, correct. So if you want to add offensive to it, we go the same combo, one, two. I'm going to circle around and pass with the right hand to drop.
Okay.
As I use my right leg to trip.
So it seems like your attack move is basically just a little evolution of the defensive move, like the defense is the underlying foundation for everything.
Correct, yes. If we relate it to the Avatar show, as the monk stay in Aang, he doesn't want to hurt anybody, so he's very around the back, maneuvering the body, you know, getting out of danger.
I like that. It's really nuanced. This is really cool. I think we need to get together with Gui, and we should bring all these to the table and design a fight scene with all of these different styles.
Let's do it. So the thing that I need for us to have today finished, having all the choreography down, but I also wanna have all the shots. I wanna know exactly what angles Vlad is thinking and combine that with the thoughts I have for where I want the camera to be at certain moments as well. So once we have that, I'm ready to go and shoot tomorrow.
Gui, this is your first punch for punch short that you're directing.
It is.
How are you feeling about it so far?
I'm honestly nervous, but I also believe that nervousness is another extension of excitement. I've always wanted to tell like a full story, and this is like a true chance for me to really get a crack at it.
Yeah, well, you did the most important thing as a director, which is to surround yourself with a lot of talented people. So yes. Really, at the end of the day, you can just be like, yeah, yeah, I don't have to do anything.
That was the goal. That was the goal.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, there's only one thing to do. We're gonna keep practicing, but then we just gotta hit him with it! Action, and we rise up, seeing all the masters saluting to one another.
Day one of production, here we are. We've been practicing, rehearsing, setting up cameras. What's your biggest challenge today?
Right now, it's trying to get this locked off seated scene and getting at least to the first section of action done as fast as possible. And action.
Master Quill, it's been far too long.
Is ideal for this situation.
I suggest contest amongst the four of us.
We are finally into the fight section, and we're gonna focus with the Ronin 4D on air and water fighting. And I chose the 4D because I like the smoothness of it, and I think it complements their style. And then I wanna switch to handheld when we get to the earth and fire fight for the energy. Vlad's in charge, which means it's gonna be a very fast and very fun shoot.
Two, one, action.
Vlad's doing all the awesome camera work. I'm over here pulling focus and making sure the exposure of the shots are dialed in. Using wireless video, wireless focus pulling, electronic focus motors, and the lens. It's good, life is easy breezy, baby.
Yeah, that was it.
I love it.
Nice work, Glenn.
Oh yeah, thank you very much, sir.
Sorry.
Yeah. Nice.
A director is supposed to be able to speak all the languages of film, right? When it comes to the technical aspect, talking to the actors, the grips, the lighting people, I realize that I'm a little ignorant in some of those things. But luckily I have like these amazing guys to help me. It's a collaborative effort for real. It really takes a team to make a film, no matter how long or short it is. My job is to really just capture the performances that I want to convey the story that I want to tell. So that means I'm finding moments within the choreography that the guys have created to portray those character traits that I want to show. All right, guys. That's a wrap! Woo! Oh, man. Oh. That was really fun. I had a really good time. I learned a lot. It's really cool watching you work, Vlad. It's really cool watching you work, Niko. And it's even cooler when seeing you both work together. Thank you.
Thank you for allowing me to be a part of it.
Of course.
Hell yeah. And listen, Gui made it extremely easy. He brought out some of the best stunt performers in the industry. I think everything went great, and I'm super duper excited to see this.
Oh yeah, I'm so pumped. Moment of truth. Mm-hmm. We finished the short, it's edited, it's put together. Now it's time for our lovely peers to watch and judge me.
I'm excited to see it.
You seem nervous.
I'm very nervous.
Well, this might make me you more nervous. Jeff is also going to tune in and watch this as well.
Great, you're saying he's here?
Hi, Jeff, he's right there.
Hey, guys.
Hi, Jeff. Well, you know what? Just like you should with a Band-Aid, you just rip it off. Let's just jump straight into it, right?
Okay, let's go.
Master Quill, it's been far too long. It's good to see you all.
There has been a disturbance caused by the Fifth Territory's absence. I will take my men.
What makes you think you are more suited to handle the taming of the Fifth Territory?
You all think you're better for the job.
I suggest a contest amongst the four of us. The winner will decide how we approach the Fifth Territory.
Dakota, it seems my Iron Mountain wall technique suits you well.
Well, since we're borrowing.
Masters, I humbly bow out of this contest.
I, too, am going to bow out, and I suggest we work together.
I bow out as well. I agree the best route would be for us to combine our efforts against the approaching threat.
I suppose for the sake of efficiency, we should go together. I apologize for my...
Please.
That's great. That's awesome.
Well done, man.
Thanks, brother. Appreciate that. You helped out a lot. What a learning experience. Jeez. Thank you, guys.
I never stopped to consider the different elements would require different fighting styles, so to speak. Because I could tell the difference in the motion. One was the two were very fluid, and two were like very grounded.
Yep.
That's really cool.
I like how the water guy has Crocs.
Yeah, actually, that's so good.
I mean, yeah, we all know these guys are super talented and great filmmakers, but Jeff actually worked on Avatar. So, Jeff, what do you think?
Every good fight has discovery for the audience, character development, and spectacle. You guys nailed spectacle. You had incredible performers, and you really showed them off. That was awesome. And Water's shoes were rad.
Thank you so much, Jeff. Your advice was really helpful in creating this short, and I know you're busy, so I won't hold up much of your time.
It's my pleasure. I am such a big fan, and I have so much respect for what you guys are doing. I look forward to seeing more, Gui. Good luck, buddy.
Hi, Jeff. Jeff. Well, that was super cool. Gui, I'm glad you got to direct the short film for Punch for Punch. You guys can check out other episodes of Punch for Punch here on YouTube, and of course, Avatar The Last Airbender is out now on Netflix. Go check it out. Bye.
Peace.